Yes, everybody, welcome back to episode number 11, maybe
11, 10, 12
of Broad and Esther. We are back on Death Squad doing our thing.
Hashtag Death Squad.
You got it. You are listening to Stephen Brody Stevens, and in front of me, we have Esther Potvitsky, everybody. Yes. Do I always say your name wrong?
A little. Esther Pavitsky, but you can just, little Esther's fine, you know.
Pavitsky.
Yeah.
Esther Pavitsky.
It's not the prettiest.
Episode 10.
That's, you know, so I said 11, it. Okay. 10's pretty good.
That yeah. seems like so few. I feel like we've done like 10,000.
Well, you add some podcasts to that. You owed some Brody Stevens.
Some Brody
projects or
super
whatever.
Super show. Yeah.
Stephen Brody Stevens Festival of Friendship.
Death Squad special editions.
I like doing Death Squad. I like doing Ice House Chronicles.
Yeah.
I like you know, coming here to Pasadena. It's a different world.
It's a different vibe. It feels good. Brody, where you been? This morning your car was gone.
Well, I was gone with it. I went to out in the valley because I wanted to look at an apartment.
No.
Yeah, I wanted to look at an apartment. There's like a buzzing in my ear, but I'll just keep going.
Try some different headphones. It might just have a loose connection with those headphones.
Could it be because I have a metal thing under the...
Maybe. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
You're looking at a new apartment. Are you leaving me and my roommate slave?
Yeah, I'm planning on that. I need a one bedroom. I need a one bedroom.
What about the one bedroom in our building that we looked at?
It's a little pricey.
Yeah.
I'm changing my headphones.
Okay.
You are listening to the Broad and Esther podcast. Broad and Esther. Esker Pavitsky.
Esker?
Esther Pavitsky.
With Brian Redband, who is
Brian Redband.
His techie work.
Yeah, it's
who
better.
Who I saw at the Comedy Store last night with Dana Diarmond.
Yeah.
Yeah, we were supposed to do a podcast last night, but fell through, so then we just went to the Comedy Store and went... Tate at Cantor's, saw Seth Rogen.
How does he look?
Is he hot?
He was in a suit. He looked like a character, like he was maybe filming a movie. He looked kind of like, I don't know, he still was a little skinnier than normal. Somebody asked for a picture. He was just like, you know.
Oh, he said no?
Well, I think it was one of those things that you could tell everybody at Cantor's was staring at the door like, oh, we want to go and get a picture of those people doing the fake phone call thing, you know, where they're just walking around, acting like they're on the phone. So he felt all this. He sensed all this. And I think he just didn't want to start, you know, the domino
effect. You do one photo, you got to do a bunch.
Yeah.
That's what happens with me.
Yeah.
That place must be pretty popular to go there just to watch for celebrities. You know, the one that's...
I don't know. I used to go there all the time. I never saw anybody at Cantor's.
Really? I went there with Zach last week.
Oh.
There you go.
And then he got guys wait outside and take pictures, or, and he just doesn't do it.
He says no?
Yeah. Rarely he'll do a picture with somebody because he doesn't want it on the internet. He doesn't like that sort of thing. He'll shake your hand. He'll sign an autograph. He'll talk to you. But he's not into the pictures, like the paparazzi type of stuff.
Yeah.
Rarely he'll do a photo. And the other thing is, yeah, once you do one, then you got to do, you're stuck doing a ton of them.
Right.
And sometimes you got places to go and do that sort of thing.
I took my mom to a Dancing with the Stars taping last week, and I asked all the quote stars to take pictures with my mom, and they all did it. I was actually surprised.
How did you get into that show?
My manager also manages one of the Dancing with the Stars guys, Apollo Ono, so he got us tickets.
So you arranged this ahead of time for your mom?
I did. It was pretty intense.
The experience or arranging it?
Everything. It was a lot to handle for me.
Did you want to go to Dancing with the Stars?
No.
Was it a good experience?
No.
It wasn't a good experience?
Well, it was okay. It made me realize that I want to be a dancer.
You used to be a dancer, right? Like
yeah.
Ballet and stuff.
You do ballet. You still do.
A little, but not really. But it made me be like, oh, I want to have a dance recital because all the pretty costumes reminded me when I was like 5. So it was good for like inspiration, but it's kind of useless inspiration since I can't really be a dancer.
Why can't you?
Well, for one, I'm Jewish.
That makes no sense.
So it makes no sense.
I don't know. I live in LA and I'm trying to be a comedian.
No, but what if you become a comedian what you are mm-hmm. and become bigger and then get something on, say, a sitcom or whatever. Then maybe you could do Dancing with the Stars as a celebrity.
That's what my mom wants. My mom thinks that my mom has no confidence in me and doesn't think that I'm anything. But then she's like, oh, I think you're ready for Dancing with the Stars. She's like delusional and thinks that I could do it.
As a celebrity?
And she told my manager that.
Well, yeah, you'd have to be a celebrity to
yeah,
be
I know,
it.
But
yeah.
She thinks that because I have enough Twitter followers that I could be on Dancing with the Stars.
That's cute.
And my manager and her, I think, are going to start hooking up.
Are you serious?
Yeah, they've been flirting.
Your dad's okay with that?
He said we could work something out.
Or he's not. He did?
Yeah. Do a little trade. Maybe he gets a little, you know, back home in Chicago.
Ew.
A little Chi-Town booty.
Ooh, pepper?
You're joking about your mom. They may be flirting.
He took us. My manager's never taken me out to a nice meal, but when my mom was in town, we went to Dominic's, and he wined and dined her. And it was.
Can I ask who your manager is?
His name's Lee Kernis.
What, is he with a big company?
Kind of.
Can I ask?
I don't think we should talk anymore about it.
Hey, look, I saw Zach Galifianakis last week, and we got a photo of him, and it was...
With Sam Tripoli.
Sam Tripoli. But I cut Sam out of that picture.
Wait, yeah, really?
Yeah.
No, you're making that up.
No, I didn't. See, that's Sam's shoulder right there. Because he posted the same photo of him and Zach, so I was...
Zach's a good guy.
He is. He was really nice, really funny. We hung him backstage and talked or watched Todd Glass. Todd Glass is one of the funniest guys in the world.
Yeah.
And he was just kind of doing like little bits for us. It was fun, man. It's fun hanging out with certain comics because they all have like the same kind of like playful, you know, they mix well. And Zach and Todd Glass, fucking great together, those two.
Nice guys.
Love both of those guys.
I mean, that's what's part of it, you know, nice people. Sometimes you're at the Comedy Store. I'm not saying they're not nice.
But I will say they're not.
Okay, you could say that, yeah. But it's a different energy. It's like you go to the Comedy Store. It's like it's a sweaty gym.
Yeah, it's mean.
It's tough. It's mean.
It's not fun.
And then you get out and go to a podcast festival, or you go backstage at a you know, a hip show. It makes you appreciate that a little more.
Definitely.
You know, and were you about to belch into the?
No.
You were about to belch into the mic.
I did.
Why were you? You did. You actually did it.
Yeah.
Why'd you do that, Esther?
I'm sorry.
To get attention? I'm too calm?
I'm sorry, Brody.
Don't be sorry.
I don't know. It's just a habit that if I do it, I do it in the mic and then blame it on someone else. But it didn't sound loud enough to where I could blame it.
I don't remember you ever burping into the microphone.
I have.
It's a new Esther.
No, it's not. This is standard. I've been doing this for years. This is my shtick.
I think she's got a lot of confidence now, Brody.
Not really.
Esther, are you going to be upset if I move out of the apartment building?
Kind of, yeah.
I need a one bedroom.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
No.
I when I'm in a studio, it feels like I'm in a prison
cell.
That's
because it's not clean.
I think it's the layout for me. I'd like to have a one bedroom where I'm going to a bedroom and I want to have a living room where I have a couch and I can watch television and I can have...
I just think you could set it up like my apartment and have that. We have a living room and upstairs.
You have an upstairs. That's funny.
What, bunk bed?
They have two beds and a cool couch to sit on.
It feels like
a little love seat.
Yeah, it's like a hotel room suite.
It is.
Mm-hmm. You just use your imagination and you'll have a one bedroom. That's what I do. I use my imagination. We have a loft. A New York City loft.
You added a loft? You built one in the apartment?
Yeah, it's just like there's an upstairs and then there's like that's where my roommate's bedroom is and then mine's off of the kitchen.
You're lying.
There's a library.
There are a lot of books.
There's a library to the right when you first walk in and there's a gym.
I'll say this. Your apartment gives off a good vibe.
Thank you.
The way you guys have it being clean and fresh smelling. And you're just right upstairs from me.
Yes.
It kind of like pushes me a little bit. I'm gonna put out that kind of energy into my next apartment.
Yeah, positive.
Positive energy. But you really... I would have to buy totally new furniture to achieve what you guys have achieved.
Well, you're going to have to do that in the new apartment anyway.
But also, maybe I have more stuff than you. I've accumulated more stuff in my lifetime over you.
You don't need it all. You don't need to be a hoarder. You can get rid of stuff.
Right. Jackets, shirts.
Yeah, anything.
Couches. I have tons of shirts I haven't worn for over a year. I think that's the rule. If you don't like it or you haven't worn it over a year.
Yeah, that's the rule that my roommate says. I don't follow it because I am a hoarder, naturally. My instincts are to hoard. And so I like to keep all of my stuff because I think that someday I'll use it as a costume. But she says that, no, if you don't wear it, you have to get rid of it. But my weight fluctuates, so that's an excuse that I use.
Yeah, exactly. You have your big pants and your small pants.
Yeah. Big Esther pants and little Esther pants.
I need a dresser. Do you have a dresser?
I have a dresser.
Does that make things easier?
It does. It does make things easier.
I want to get a dresser.
For socks and stuff, I think. I use it for socks,
bras, underwear.
Yeah.
What about t-shirts? Where do you put those? You hang them?
I like t-shirts in the dresser, but that's not how the system that my roommate allows me.
She won't allow you.
You mean like this t-shirt, Brody? Like this nice t-shirt?
Oh my God, that's so cool.
That you can get on BrodyStevens.com.
It looks great on you.
Yeah.
It's BrodyStevens.BigCartel.com.
You might want to spell Big Cartel because it's spelled with a K, I think. Or isn't it?
I think it's with a C.
Is it with a C?
Yeah.
Oh, I used to be on Big Cartel. I should know this.
You're not on it anymore?
No.
It's why not? Right. It's a bad experience?
It's just not set up. It's really basic and it's really good if you have like one product.
I have three products.
Yeah, I know. But it's like how it works with PayPal and how it just works with like the shipping parts of it and stuff like that. It's kind of like a clusterfuck.
So I just wanted to... Actually, the shirt you're wearing, Esther, is similar to my baseball shirt that I'm selling.
Oh, yeah. Cool. I love baseball shirts.
Well, then you're in line for a Stephen Brody Stevens T-shirt.
I love that shirt. The 818's on the back.
818?
Yeah.
Enjoy It's on the back, right? Enjoy it, 818. Yeah, I was just a fan. JR was a fan of Death Squad and a fan of my stuff, and he was just pushing it like, I can do T-shirts for you. I designed it. Then he designed it, then he wore it out. That kind of like showed me something.
Right.
And then basically what he said was he would ship them out for me. He would set up the store for me.
Oh,
he's done all
so
that
cool.
stuff.
Is this him right here?
No, it's not him. I guess that's a Raider fan.
Who's that guy? It's his
boyfriend.
No, I don't think he's gay.
I want to have t-shirts too. I love that t-shirt. That's exactly
Is that my audience? This guy?
This guy?
Oh, I don't think
no,
so.
No, I don't think that's your audience now.
No.
Tattooed cuties.
I have like an aging hipster audience.
An aging hipster audience? What am I?
I'm trying to go for the Asian hipsters.
Really?
It's a hard market to crack.
You know what? I was in Silver Lake the last weekend, and I've decided that if you want to fit in Silver Lake, you have to wear really ugly clothes that make your body look bad and then just have a really pretty face. It's all you need.
And some kind of accessory, like a feather or a rabbit's,
feather in your cap.
A rabbit's foot. On
holding it.
That's why I want to go back to the Valley. I felt so comfortable today looking at that one-bedroom apartment right down the street from where I previous lived.
Like what area?
Are you welcome back in the Valley now?
I think so. I went back there today and it felt right. Valley Village area.
Oh, yeah,
I like
that.
That area.
Yeah, me too.
You know, I enjoyed my apartment building where I was at, but I knew I had to get a studio or a one bedroom at that time. And then I had my little episode there and I didn't get evicted, so it's not on my record, right. But they asked me to leave.
What about like North Hollywood area? Like I've been hanging out there a lot lately and it's completely different now. It's actually pretty nice now what they're doing with around the arts area district.
Yeah, I might look at some places over there.
Good prices is what I'm saying.
You think so?
Yeah. I know somebody that just got a pretty big two bedroom for like $1,300.
I love good prices.
Really? In a nice building?
Yeah. Nice locks, you know, gates and everything like that.
Right around that NoHo Entertainment's Arts Center.
Yeah. Will you tell us who? Is it a pretty girl?
It is a pretty girl, but no, I won't tell you.
Okay, I'll follow.
Could I get I could still get a decent one bedroom in Los Angeles in the Valley
where
for
$1,200. Mm-hmm. What?
And then if I sell T-shirts, do live comedy, book another TV show, do some audience warm up, I'll be able to afford that apartment.
And maybe in the future get a normal mattress instead of the air mattress.
I'm gonna get a normal mattress.
Are we still talking? We can't talk about this.
Why?
It's just, it's old news. It's like we got to be updated.
We're updating them.
Bring us updated information.
That is updated.
New and...
I still have an air mattress.
No.
So you're trying to light a fire under me to get a mattress.
I'm just trying to just roll it on out.
I saw Brody do a hour, 10-minute set the other day.
Whoa.
And I laughed my ass off the whole time.
Where?
Thank you, Brian.
Brody, your comedy's back to kicking ass again. You're just destroying. It's awesome seeing.
Well, I appreciate that. I'm very calm. I'm very focused. I still need more jokes and material. But recently, the last couple weeks, I've just been saying, you know what? I'm going to be nice to myself. I'm going to do crowd work. I'll do a couple jokes up front, then I'll do crowd work, and then maybe I'll get back into my jokes. I've been hit over the head so much about like material, jokes, material, and I'm not having a great time. You know, it's like, okay, let me work in some new jokes and also let me do some crowd work. But you can't do crowd work in big auditoriums unless you have a cordless mic and they let you walk through the crowd, which maybe that will be something I do.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and it, my crowd work, it doesn't matter. I mean, obviously I'm more advantaged doing the crowd work here in Los Angeles because I know everything about it. But I could also go, I ask people like, what did you do today? What do you want to be when you get older? Did you go to, I just ask any question. It doesn't have to specifically pertain to LA. But the deal is, thank you, Brian. My comedy has been going better. And I think part of it is, I'm going to mention it. And I know I'm not going to go, this podcast is not about it. I'll save that for my other podcast. But I think the mood stabilizer.
No.
Stop it, Esther.
No meds today, Brody.
But I'm telling you why my comedy's gotten better.
Yeah, it seems like you're in a better mood and everything like that. Is that true? Are you feeling 100% now? Or are you feeling
80? I have my good days and bad days.
It seems like you're great right now.
Yeah, you do seem great.
Well, because I'm getting things done. I had a good show last night. I looked at that apartment today. I looked at another apartment today. I'm going to look at some apartments tomorrow.
You were gone early this morning.
Yeah, because I had to go look at the apartment. I had a 11 o'clock meeting. And I went to Starbucks in the Valley.
Whoa.
And exactly. I went back to my old Starbucks.
Where you're
and it
the
felt
sheriff?
Right. It felt the sheriff of Starbucks.
I'm coffee bean police now.
You are?
Inspired by you, yeah. I tell all the people who are smoking that they have to stop smoking. And one time there was two models eating, or they were drinking on the patio, and they left their garbage, and I followed them to their car and asked them if they were done with it. And they looked at me like I was crazy.
What's wrong with you? And I also been seeing on your Instagram, which you guys are all on Instagram
now. Esther Monster on Instagram, Red Band, and Brody, what's yours?
Brode 36.
What? Brode 36.
So mine's Esther Monster.
36 was my number in college.
Oh, okay.
I like that number.
Yeah, that's cool. I don't like how Instagram and you can't go just the Instagram.com. You know what I mean? Like you can't.
I know.
It's stupid.
And that's annoying.
And I also don't like, but I heard they fixed, like if you tag somebody in Instagram so that it will be on your Twitter, it won't tag them in an Instagram if their name's different.
Oh, you know, that's what I mean? Good. Yeah, because, I have a different name.
But I think they fixed that.
You've been following my Instagrams?
Yeah, I've been following your you walking around with a stuffed animal.
Oh.
And why are you really walking around with stuffed animals like a kid? I mean, are you still in this phase of little Esther, like I'm a little child?
First of all, it's not a phase. second of all, I adopted a new pet. His name is, I think the official name is Sprinkles. And he's a Webkinz. Webkinz are stuffed animals that they come with online codes and you could play with them. You just type the code in, and then there's like a whole world. And I have about 16 Webkinz. I've been collecting them since I was in college. And I just for the first time in over a year got a new one. So, yes, I'm excited about him. And I've been bringing him with me to lunch and to lots of other things. He's usually in my bag, but he's at home right now.
So you are serious about this?
I think there's nothing wrong with it. I think that... It's I've brought him on stage a few times and he's soft and cute, and who doesn't want something soft and cute in their arms?
Esther, do you need some of my mood stabilizers? I have antipsychotics. You don't need a mood stabilizer, you would need an antipsychotic with that.
Yeah.
That speech you just gave.
I agree. It seems like you're trying to forget something that happened that drastic, like in your life when you were a child or something.
You always maybe. Say that.
Well, you're carrying around stuffed animals.
What's the big deal?
I don't know.
I don't get it. It's, little kids do
you're
it.
You're an adult.
You're not a little kid.
I'm not a little kid.
You're little, but you're not a little kid.
You're 29 years old.
I'm Esther. Not 29, okay? I'm 20.
You need to tell people that. You're real age.
I'm 24, and my heart is
12.
Two?
Two?
No.
Two?
It's just I don't understand what's the rush.
That's good to say if you're 14 and your mom's like, look, you're 14 now. You can't be carrying around stuffed animals like an 8-year-old anymore.
I just, yeah, what's the rush?
What's the rush to get out of carrying stuffed animals?
You're going to be one of those people with the stuffed animals in your car.
You're an adult.
One of those people. Those people?
Yeah.
Brian, mm-hmm. Now we're those people?
Yeah.
I mean, there are older people into stuffed animals.
It's not that I'm into stuffed animals. It's I have one that I really care about right now.
And you take them places with you.
Yeah. If I go to a coffee shop and do writing, I have them there with me. It's just like having someone with you at all times.
Do people ask you what is the...
I've gotten looks, but nobody's ever said anything to me. Friends have gotten a little irritated and, you know, confused. And they're like, oh... Damn.
Are you doing it for any a comedic effect at all?
Not really. I think that it may appear that way. However, it's just, why not? Why not? So I got the stuffed animal. I like it. And I'm just going to be myself. And
What's your name on Instagram again?
Esther Monster. ESTHERMONSTER.
What's the stuffed animal's Instagram?
Good question. Coming soon.
So what is his name? Sprinkles?
It's Sprinkle Monster, but Sprinkles is his nickname.
Did you order him online?
No.
Did somebody special give it to you?
It was a gift. It was a surprise gift from someone that knew I liked Webkinz.
I used to have a stuffed animal, like a little monkey. Used to carry around.
Oh, yeah? What's his name?
Chaka.
That's cute.
Where's Chaka now?
I don't know what I did with him.
Oh, well, that's responsible.
But I liked him. He was like a little it was like a little monkey from Animal Practice, the Bobby Lee show.
That's canceled. You know that, right?
Yeah. Why did it get canceled?
That's what happens to TV shows.
It's really, I mean, you could feel for the actors on it. Like they have to get another job. That's real life. If a show gets canceled.
Yeah, but I don't feel bad. Shows get canceled all the time. Look at Dane Cook had a sitcom, and it got canceled before it even got to air.
Dane Cook Why
had
did a that? Sitcom?
Yeah, he had a show on NBC called Last Caller about him playing a radio DJ, and they shot 4 episodes, and NBC was like, never mind, and they canceled it.
I did not know that.
Yeah.
Is that a blow to the ego?
It's
if you're Dane Cook,
yeah,
is that devastating?
Yeah, I saw him at the Laugh Factory 2 days ago, and he was kind of cold to me, and so maybe.
And he's usually pretty nice.
He's usually okay, yeah.
He's nice to me.
He's only nice when he bumps me, though.
Right, he was like nice to me when he bumped me the other night.
Yeah, he's real nice when he bumps you, but then otherwise it's like.
Broads, do you mind if I go up and?
Yeah, it's like, what am I supposed to do? Just because you sold all those albums, I can't say no.
It's pretty amazing that he's done arenas and all that stuff.
It is. Yeah, I liked his CD when I was like 10.
Russell Peters is doing Staples Center.
Yeah, he's been at the Comedy Store the last 3 days.
Oh, I saw him last night.
Hilarious, man. I love Russell Peters. Is he maybe one of the best comics, like nicest, greatest guys?
Yeah.
I think he might be.
Super nice guy.
Yeah.
Beyond nice.
Yeah.
If you're watching this right now live on Ustream, Russell Peters will be on the Jimmy Kimmel live show tonight.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Are you going?
I was going to go, but I can't. I have too many other things.
He's playing Staples?
Mm-hmm.
How do I not even know who he is if he's playing Staples? What's he famous from?
Stand up all over the world.
Yeah, he's huge.
Is he really funny?
Yeah, he's pretty funny.
And what, did he sell well at Staples?
I don't know.
I was just at Staples for Madonna.
Oh, how was that concert?
It was so fun. It was amazing.
Was it packed?
It was packed. It was so cool.
You bring your stuffed animal?
No, I didn't have him yet.
Was the crowd mostly...
He wasn't born yet.
Mostly gay?
Yeah, mostly gay.
Gay guys?
Yeah, I went with my gay friend. We had really good seats. I love Madonna.
So you could see Madonna pretty close?
Yeah.
Up close? Was there... I saw the Black Keys at the Staples Center
recently.
Oh,
you saw that?
Oh, I remember
How
that.
Was that?
It was great. Really good. And I'm not a huge Black Keys fan necessarily. I know a couple of their songs, a few of them, but then I knew a few more that they played. I go, oh, they'd sing that song too. And then they had other songs that they just sounded great, and the energy, it was really good. And the sound at the Staples is good. I've heard bad things about it. The acoustics aren't good there, but sounded great. How did Madonna sound?
Good, really good.
Did the acoustics sound good?
I don't really know much about acoustics, but I think they were great.
Could you feel the beat?
I could feel the beat in my heart.
What songs did she sing?
She sang so many good ones. She sang some from the new album, some from some of the classics. She sang Like a Prayer. She sang Holiday. She sang a new version of Like a Virgin. Yeah, it was great.
Is she still ripped, buff?
She's got a great body. She's sexy.
Was there big TV monitors there?
Yeah, there must have been, yeah. Yeah.
Like, could you see her up close?
Yeah, we were on the floor. My friend Matt, who is gay and
he's gay,
awesome, took me, and we had really great seats.
Was it general admission? Was it standing on the floor, or were you in chairs?
It was standing, and it was there were chairs. But for Lady Gaga, when you're on the floor, it's like you have to get there early so you can get close. It's general admission for the floor.
You saw Lady Gaga at Staples Center?
I saw it, yeah, at Nokia and then at Staples.
How was that concert?
Amazing.
Who's more amazing, Madonna or Lady Gaga?
I can't answer that.
Really?
Mm-mm.
What would most people say?
I don't know. I think most people that grew up with Madonna would say Madonna, and then the people who grew up with Gaga would say Gaga.
Gaga.
Yeah.
People don't call her Lady Gaga, it's Gaga.
If you're a little monster, you can call her Gaga or Mother Monster.
Is she still getting more popular?
Yeah.
She's just growing, Lady Gaga.
Yeah.
Is it because her songs, her music, or her message?
All of that. Her songs, her message, everything.
Did you see her with the new hair that she has, the fiber optic hair that she was wearing in one of her videos? Or I think she posted it maybe on her Twitter or something like that. She has this new fiber optic hair where each strand is like a different color. So when she wears it at night, it like glows, and then she can do all this shit. It's actually pretty cool. I think they invented it for her only, you know. So it's kind of cool where she's kind of has this weird thing where she's also creating products that haven't been done before. By the way, here's a picture of you with your stuffed animal. You look like...
Oh, thank you.
What's that girl from Jersey Shore? Snooki.
Oh, good.
With the hat on and the stuffed animal and checking your phone, like, even though you know somebody's taking a photo of you. And you're wearing sunglasses in a parking garage.
Yeah, you know, that was the hat I got from Ethel's 90th birthday party on Cape Cod 2012.
Did you go there?
No, it was a friend gave me that. And that's Sprinkle Monster. And yes, I was pretending to look at my phone while someone took a photo.
Who took that photo?
Are you happy? My friend Jenna. My friend Jennifer from
Where were you going? Crunch, or were you going to...
I think we were going to Starbucks to do some homework.
Homework?
Oh.
Are you in school? What grade are you in? God. What kind of homework?
Well, my friend Jenna, I went to college with her, so we always used to get together to do homework. And now that she's moved out to LA to pursue her dreams of becoming my assistant / friend... we call it homework, but when we say we're going to do homework, it just means we're going to Starbucks or Coffee Bean, we're going to get a tea, and we're going to have our laptops, and we're just going to talk a little bit, but like do our own stuff.
What do you do on your laptop?
I blog, and sometimes I have to memorize stuff, and then I write.
What do you write in on your laptop? What program?
It depends. I'll use Final Draft, or I like to use Google Docs.
So are you writing a script?
I just wrote a script, yeah.
What about writing jokes? You doing that too?
Yeah, but that I usually just kind of do on the fly.
You freehand those?
No, like, I don't just, like, sit down and, like, I'm going to write jokes. It's like, it'll come up naturally, or it just doesn't.
Will you write them down, or you put it in your phone?
Yeah, I use an app on my iPhone that I just discovered. It's called Wunderlist.
Right.
And I use that to take notes.
And that's so you put your notes into Wunderlist.
Mm-hmm.
When you're on your laptop, you're working on a script or you're blogging.
Or Google Doc.
Google Docs.
And...
Can you write a script in Google Docs?
No, but you can write an outline in Google Docs.
Right. And then will you blog in Google Docs, or do you
blog? No, I blog straight on Tumblr.
How often do you do that?
Whenever I think about something to blog, or whenever I'm bored or just want to, or feel like I haven't done it. Sometimes I like blog all like at once. Like I'll do like 8 posts at once because I get, oh my God, what if people, because I have so many blogs that I love and I'll check them. Like I, whatever, I know it's like it's lame, but like maybe not. I used to check like all the, I'm not going to say who, but I used to check blogs, people's blogs all the time. And if they didn't update it for like 3 days, I would get really upset. And then you just stop checking. So sometimes if I go a few days without updating my blog, I'm like, oh my God, people are going to get mad and stop checking.
I used to have a blog on my website. I used to have an email that I would send out once or twice a week. I'd write a I'd write a funny story and then list where I was performing. And I did that about twice a week.
That's really cool.
Yeah, you used to have a pretty big website with like tons of links, and you were always updating it with photos, and like you were really into it for a while. What happened?
Yeah, I just kind of got out of it because it was, you know, Twitter started taking off, Facebook started taking off, MySpace was, you know, came and went. So to me, I just kind of did Facebook.
Right.
My website. More people were going on Facebook, so I would do that. And that, so Facebook and to a lesser extent MySpace. You burped again.
I'm sorry, Brody. I'm sorry.
Where was I? Facebook or MySpace?
MySpace.
Okay. So Facebook or MySpace to me kind of took away my website. Like, why do I want to blog on my website when I can just do it on MySpace and Facebook?
Because once Facebook and MySpace die, like MySpace dies, you lose all those blog posts.
Right. But you know what? I ended up not doing that many of them.
Right.
It kind of like took me away from my website and I never came back.
Right.
You know, and then Twitter came about.
So now podcasting, you don't really have to write down things anymore. You just say it.
Right. And that's what I like about podcasting is that this is saved forever. Number one, I'm not writing anything.
It's not really saved forever.
Mm-hmm. Once this is distributed out into the public, it's like everybody has a copy of this. So even if you lose it or if the place burns down that has your MP3 on it, there's at least a couple thousand people with this MP3. You know?
Nothing is forever.
Well, you know what I mean.
Yeah.
So podcasting, I've kind of like evolved to that from email list to blogging on my website. To go into Facebook, go into MySpace, then go into Facebook, and I've migrated over to Twitter. So I tweet a lot. You know, you've seen that I have a lot of tweets. That's kind of just replacing my blog stuff.
Yeah.
Instead, maybe I should write a Tumblr blog. I don't know, just more long form. But
Instagram.
I do Instagram, and I do Twitter. And sometimes Twitter can be a little too much for me. Sometimes Instagram could be a little much, but not really. But more so like Twitter is just, it's a lot of information coming at you. And then you get addicted to it and you're reading it. You get your news off it. But then you're not going to CNN.com anymore. You're not going to ESPN.com. For me, I'm not because I just look at it on Twitter.
I think that's okay. I like keeping it simple.
Right, but I don't know how well I'm getting the story or how well it's sticking with me. You know, I see a little, I mean, I'll follow a link up there. They say, you know, support store, and I will follow the link, but it seems like I'd retain more if I read a newspaper. Like I haven't read a newspaper forever, you know, it's like,
well, I think
like, that's normal.
Yeah. I think that's becoming normal, but I still like magazines and books sometimes.
Yeah. I'm trying to get into books and, I mean, part of that is my apartment, you know? I don't have a couch. I'm sleeping on an air mattress. I don't have a separate room. But you know what? I saw a nice one bedroom today.
And that's, we've all known that you don't have a couch and you have an air mattress. And we did the last podcast, talked about it. So that's on you.
Gosh, this is the new harsh Esther.
It's confidence. We should probably talk about why she has so much confidence.
It's not confidence. I just think that I want Brody to be happy and have the things that he should have.
Okay, look at the things I've done. I agree with you. I'm not disagreeing with you. But since then, since our last podcast or since our last serious sit-down conversation, I've gone on to do my own podcast.
Mm-hmm.
Twice a week. Sorry, Brian. Are you upset at me?
What?
You know, Brian gets weird about that. But
you did audience warm up for The Burn.
Yes, I've done audience warm up for The Burn. I was on The Burn. I started a t-shirt shop.
Yeah, you know what? You're right. You've been doing a lot. You've done more than I have.
Actually, Brody's done more than most of the... I think anyone on Death Squad, you know, Brody has, since the last Brody and Esther, has done more than anyone that's on Death Squad. You know, like, he's got his own t-shirt now. He's got his own fucking stickers. He's doing something that every single show on Death Squad should have been doing from day one. He took the initiative.
I feel like I'm getting yelled at.
You're not getting yelled at.
We're just saying that Brody's kicking fucking ass right now. You need to recognize.
Well, I see, like, you know what? People have asked me to sell t-shirts for the last couple years. So I started that t-shirt thing. Is it the best thing ever? No. I mean, but it's good. It's good that I'm doing it.
Yeah.
Just like maybe I'm in a good mood today because I looked at apartments. I looked at two different apartments. I did another podcast earlier, and not as fun as this, of course. And I mean, podcasting has helped me. You know, it's helped me feel better. It's therapeutic. You know, I think the more I can do, the better off. Mm-hmm.
I've been exercising.
You've been going to Crunch.
Yeah, and basically.
Do you like it over there?
I don't go that much. I do other stuff too. I do like dancer workout stuff.
How gay is that Crunch?
That's a super gay Crunch. Isn't that the gayest Crunch ever?
Okay, settle down. There's gay guys there.
Right.
But
is it overrun by gay guys? Is it uncomfortable
like
if you're a straight guy?
I don't think so.
Equinox
like
is a gay gym?
Yeah, Equinox is super gay. Super gay. Not like Crunch.
Carlos works out there, our friend Carlos.
Yeah, Carlos works out at the gay Equinox. Yeah.
Why does he do that?
Because he's gay.
Yeah.
Because Carlos is gay.
He's not gay.
Yeah, he's a...
No, he's straight.
He's gay.
You think he's gay?
No, he's gay for me.
What do you mean gay for you?
I don't know. Everyone makes fun of Carlos because he's my best friend. So they say he's like my...
Your gay friend?
Kind of.
Did he take you to the Madonna concert?
No, okay. He didn't.
Carlos is a good guy. We go hiking together.
Carlos, yeah. He's one of my closest friends. We get lunch together every day.
At Veggie Grill.
Uh-huh.
I need to go with you guys.
Yeah, you should come.
How come you don't invite me?
I don't know. It was just a thing that started. We go at Veggie Grill. We go to Veggie Grill. Oh, wait, I shouldn't be saying this.
But nobody knows which one.
Well, we also said Crunch.
Oh, well, but who says Crunch and Veggie Grill are the same? Maybe you go to a different Veggie Grill.
Anyway.
What are you laughing about, Esther?
Let me see your abs. Let me see what's going on your...
you want to see my abs?
Yeah, let's take a look at this.
Are you losing weight?
Not really. And these are maternity jeans. They're stretchy.
That's nice. Now pull up the shirt a little more.
Yeah, pull up your shirt a little more.
Esther, show us your bra.
No.
Come on.
Oh my God, I'm so fat still.
Are you losing weight? Do you want to lose weight?
Yeah, I'm always trying to lose weight, but it's really hard because I'm addicted to cupcakes and black licorice and...
Cupcakes are probably not the best.
No, and black licorice I go overboard too.
Is there sugar?
It's so good. Yeah, it's got a lot of sugar in it. And Sprinkles Cupcakes in Beverly Hills is really creating an issue.
Do you take Sprinkles to Sprinkles?
I do. Great question.
You really love Sprinkles.
The cupcakes or the dog?
Your animal.
Yeah.
Your
Webkins.
Webkins.
So weird.
When I told Carlos about Webkins, he thought that I said Webkids and that like it was a gang I started called Webkids. No? Anybody?
Are you itching a hemorrhoid?
No, I'm just getting cut.
Hey,
off a
that's
hemorrhoid.
Inappropriate.
I don't have a hemorrhoid.
You don't? You ever had one?
I don't think so. I hope not to get one, but it could.
I have something I want you guys to try sometime.
Okay.
I've been doing it for 3 days now.
Baby wipes?
I try stuff.
It's called ZMA Max. We had this guy on that created this thing on the Rogan podcast.
Oh, I saw something about the Twitter.
What is it?
It's like this shit you take right before you go to bed. It's got zinc in it, And it puts you into like a super, super deep sleep. Like, yeah. You know, there's different levels of sleep. This takes you right to like whatever, the sixth or seventh level.
Beyond REM.
Yeah. And it just makes you sleep hardcore, and it gives you zinc, you know, which a lot of people's bodies are depleted of zinc, and it has some other shit in it. But anyways, what I like about it is I wake up. I usually wake up like I feel like I'm tired, but I just woke up. I just slept for 7 or 8 hours, but I feel like I need to go back to bed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's me every day.
Amen.
And I think it's because when I sleep, I don't get to that deep sleep. I think I get to like a 1 or 2 level sleep, and I'm just kind of coasting while sleeping, so I wake up tired. This just knocks me out. I wake up so refreshed for once, and it helps your body, you know, like if you're feeling sick or anything, it helps, you know, take care of your body.
Yeah, with the zinc.
And it, you know, it's a lot of people, like athletes take it to, you know, to get healthy or to...
I want it.
Yeah. So I recommend just trying it out. It's on Amazon.
You've been on it for 2 nights?
3 days.
And you notice the difference?
I know. Like, I'm right now, I'm not tired. Like, I usually am like just barely coasting through the day, always tired and stuff.
Do you take the brain med?
No.
Alpha Brain?
No, Alpha Brain.
No, I don't take any of it.
You did, though?
I used to, yeah.
Do you have any of it here for us to try?
Did it work for you?
I felt like it did for a while, but I don't know if it's just, you know, like here's the thing I think. If it's supposed to improve your brain function and you're supposed to remember things better, if you're supposed to doing... It didn't do any of that for me. It felt like it did for a bit, but I don't know if it was just me thinking it did.
Right.
But then I was like, wait, I'm on this, but I'm still, I can't remember a phone number or I can't remember that person's name. You know, I don't know. I don't like taking pills every day. I don't like taking pills, period. So if I'm going to do anything, it's just going to be vitamins. And I like the sleeping thing, though. It makes sense to me. Knock you out.
Does it really, like, when you take it, do you fall asleep right away?
About 30 minutes, you start getting that, like, I could barely keep my eyes open
type. I love that. Thing. Yeah. That's like, I feel like, because I've never really done drugs or tried alcohol, but I feel like if there's one thing that I would like to be able to feel is that tired feeling.
Yeah. You don't have that?
No, I have a really hard time falling asleep at night. So if I, like, my dream is to just get into a bed and just feel tired and go to sleep. Mm-hmm. And like, it's like my biggest fear. That's why I hate going to bed. And I've always had anxiety about going to bed ever since I was little, because I know, oh my God, when I go to bed, the lights are going to be out and there's going to be nothing going on. And I'm just going to be laying there freaking out.
Yeah.
I've been lucky that I've always been able to fall asleep. I just put on the radio, or I'll put on a comedy set that I did. That way I'll cry myself to sleep. But I put on a comedy set, or I'll read. You know, I'll go on the internet and read up on stuff. I mean, usually if I read on the internet on my iPhone, it will keep me up a little bit, but uh-huh. I do end up getting tired. Knock on wood, I haven't had sleep issues since now or ever.
Podcasts are good for also listening to what, but then sometimes they distract you and you want to stay up and listen to them.
Yeah, unless I'm really drunk, I could probably fall asleep. Or if I just had really good sex, I usually get really sleepy.
That's all guys. But girls don't get that.
Yeah, but other than that, like I'm just like...
Or masturbate.
Yeah, masturbate works too. But I lay there and just pretty much watch TV and wait for me to get that sleepy sleep.
Yeah.
Which usually takes hours, and I'm up till 5:30 in the morning every day.
Yep.
So this is cool. I mean, the thing I think I need to do, though, is take it... Like, force myself. Like, even though I'm not tired at 11:30, I'm home. Just take it anyway.
Yeah.
And then a half hour later, I'm going to be like, I'm just going to go to bed.
What is it called again?
ZMA Max. I got the kind that's Muscle Farm, PHARM, ZMA Max. It's on Amazon. You go to Doug.com, DUGGED.com, and buy it. And it's grass-fed zinc. It's like the healthiest, like materials in it, you know, it's legit.
Who is the person that made this? And that
Joe Rogan?
No. This is from a company called Muscle Farm, but the guy that created the idea of this,
Lance Armstrong,
he was on one of our podcasts, and he said that it's this guy that used to give steroids to all the boxers and fighters back in the day, and all the pride guys. He used to be the doctor that used
to. But why would they want steroids to fall asleep?
This is a natural way to build up steroids. If when your body is You see, when you get older, your body loses steroids.
Wait, I thought steroids are bad. And
testosterone.
Legal.
Testosterone you lose.
Yeah, you lose testosterone. This helps naturally build it. Well, females already start building it. When, you know, they get more the older they get. Guys lose
testosterone.
It.
Lifting weights helps build up testosterone.
Does it? I think so.
Yeah. I'm 42, and I don't feel like the way I used to.
Yeah.
But you know what? I'm not going to the gym. I haven't been to the gym for a year, and I'm on, you know, I'm on some medication. I would take those supplements. That's the one thing I'm going to do when I get back into my one bedroom. I'm going to have my supplements. I'm going to find a kitchen that I like. I'm going to have my supplements in there, and I'm going to join a gym. That's what I'm going to do. I'm not going to work out at home right now. You know, I used to work out of my home, but I used to work at a gym. But I'm going to get a gym membership. I'm already getting a bed. I have somebody help out there picking it out for me. I'm going to get a couch. And I saw this apartment today, and maybe I'll get it, but I'll look at a couple more. But I think that's going to help me.
Yeah.
I think the bed thing, well, we already talked about this, but yeah, I think the bed thing's going to talk
about. Of course, but I think the one bedroom, getting out, I mean, I have nothing against our building, but it's just Hollywood. I like Runyon, don't get me wrong, Runyon Canyon. But Hollywood, just seeing the desperation, just seeing the homeless guys around there, it's dirty. It's
Dirty, we don't live in that bad of an area.
Yeah, you do. It's called Hollywood.
Hey, just Hollywood is where dreams come true. It's where we go.
Yeah, we get shot.
Marilyn
we get
Monroe.
Fucking naked people walking around on meth.
Marilyn Monroe's from Hollywood. How could it be that bad?
I smelled a flower on Sunset by the mistake recently, and a little droplet of water went on my nose when I smelled it. And I'm like, oh, that's bum pee. What am I doing smelling this flower on Sunset?
Could have been, yeah.
That's what?
Bum pee. A bum probably pissed all over that flower. That's what that water
is. Bum pee. It's rain or like succulent stuff.
It's homeless liquid.
Yeah.
But I'm saying that
liquid homeless.
It's getting to me a little bit. Seeing, you know, if you go on La Brea and then start going in that direction around there, La Brea and Sunset and La Brea all through the, you know, the Walk of Fame or whatever it is. It's like a downer for me.
Yeah.
Just to like walk through there or drive through there, and for me personally. Where I'm at, and the fact that I grew up in the Valley and I was living in the Valley, and the Valley is a little more peaceful. I was just there today looking, you know, getting my coffee out there. It's like maybe that's where I need to go.
Yeah.
And I can still make it to the Comedy Store in 15 minutes at night. I could still make it to the Laugh Factory in 15 minutes at night. I could still, you know, I'm not going to be doing Runyon Canyon as much, if any, but I'm going to join a gym. Yeah. I need to make these changes in my life.
It's hard to know where to live.
Yeah, but if I can go back to where I was when I was feeling good, which was on Laurel Canyon and Magnolia, right around there, that was where my apartment was. I was there for 5 years. I wanted to move, but I wanted to stay in the same area. It was either stay in the same area or move to Hollywood. So when I had to move after my incident, I said, why don't I just move to Hollywood? Because I'll be closer to the clubs, and it was just a different scene for me.
Yeah.
But it ended up, there's positives being at where we're at. But for me, where I'm at, Stephen Brody Stevens.
.com.
It's still up. .com. I feel like the Valley is where I need to be, and if I'm at in Valley Village, it keeps me close enough to Hollywood and everything, and okay. I'm familiar with it.
Okay, fine. You can go to the Valley.
But I'll tell you what, when I pull into the parking structure in our building, I love seeing your car there.
Yeah, same. I look for yours. I didn't see it this morning.
Yeah, but you shouldn't be looking for a car and then making sure there's no body around it also, you know?
No, I don't do that. No, but I always my parking spot is deeper into the lot, deeper into the garage, so I see Esther's, you
know. On the way.
So when you look for mine, do you see Brody's out. Good for him. Are you happy?
Yeah. I'm like, where's Brody?
He's doing something.
Mm-hmm.
And then what about when you come home and you see my car there?
Then I'm like, oh, Brody's home. Good to know.
See, I'm more excited when your car's there. You seem to be more excited for me when my car isn't there.
Well, you set up that way because you were like, are you excited that I'm out doing stuff? So yeah, I am.
So am I. It's good when my car's not there.
Yeah.
I need to be doing stuff.
Yeah.
Some nights your car isn't there.
That's because you got some.
What? No. No, you guys, stop. That's not true.
Are we allowed to talk about social stuff?
Not social media.
Sprinkles.
I'm starting to get some chicks into me now through my podcasting.
You got chicks?
Don't be so surprised.
Not surprised.
I did a show down in Irvine.
Uh-huh.
And I'll be there tonight.
You're going to be down in Irvine tonight?
Comedy Juice tonight, 10 o'clock. Free tickets on my Twitter.
Enjoy
I
it.
I want to go.
This girl came up to me after the show and said, I just want to give you a hug. I mean, she's heard me on different podcasts or whatever. And she goes, I want to give you a hug. And oh, you're real. God, I just want to, I'm kind of nervous right now. She was, oh, you're real. I just want to give you a hug. And she was cute.
Really?
She like, she didn't feel sorry for me. She was like intimidated by me, like I was a celebrity, but she also felt for me because of what I've been going through. And I do go on a lot of podcasts and talk about it. It's a form of therapy for me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, today's a good day.
Art therapy.
Yeah, art therapy. You know, I podcast therapy.
You should talk to those girls more.
Right. I need to call her. And then
Do you have her number?
I do have her number.
Whoa, Brody, this is a huge update that you're just leaving out.
Yeah, you've been texting her? You've been doing emoticons?
It's home phone. I need to call her. I haven't done it yet.
It's a home phone?
Yeah, she doesn't have a cell. She doesn't...
Oh, whoa, what the... Are you being serious?
Brody, come on. A home phone?
It's a home phone.
She doesn't have a cell? What, is she married or
something? She doesn't want to deal with being bothered all the time.
Is she 80 years old?
No, she is actually... She was cute, good body, blonde, attractive face. I would say in her 20s to late 20s, something like that.
Is she in a wheelchair?
No, she was...
Brian, I'm just trying to figure out the home phone thing. I'm just like, I didn't know that existed anymore. It's like saying I have a black and white
home phone?
TV.
Yeah.
I'll call and find out more information. She didn't seem crazy.
Well, they never seem crazy at first. It takes like, it could take up to 30 days.
Right, for that to come out.
Yes.
Well.
But that's okay.
At least try to get some, you know?
Yeah, try to get some.
It's
I think I'd feel better.
About that.
And well, then.
Sure. I think for Brody it is.
And then I did a show with Neil Hamburger and Funny. Andy Kindler.
Funny.
Rob Delaney.
Funny.
John Daly.
Funny.
Mom.
Marcus Monroe, I think is a he's a juggler. He was good. Anyway, so I did that show with Neil Hamburger, Tim Heidecker.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah. And after the show, I talked to a girl at the talk. We went to Taco Zone, which is a popular taco truck.
Taco Zone?
Yeah.
Huh.
And I talked to her, and we seemed to be hitting it off. Not hitting it off, but talking.
What color hair does she have?
Black.
Hmm.
You may know her. I don't know. She's on Twitter.
Oh, really?
But we were just talking, and she was attractive. And then I sent her a message on Twitter, because we follow each other.
A DM. On the DM.
And then she DM'd me back, and then I DM'd her again, then she DM'd me back, and then I DM'd her again.
And then you DP'd.
Stop.
Oh. Then it stopped. Then it stopped. I think when I asked her out to get coffee.
Oh.
Was that wrong?
No.
Yeah, I felt right. Maybe I should follow up.
So you know what you should do? Just be cute about it, though. Be like, oh, you don't want to get coffee with Brody?
No.
You don't want to get coffee with Brody, bro?
Absolutely not. Do not do that.
I'm going to say that.
Don't say want to get coffee. No.
Sorry if I spooked you with the coffee.
No. Don't say that
No,
either.
Don't say that. Don't be you a
wanna,
Josh Merowitz.
You know what you want to do is you want to.
Much love.
If you have something to do, invite her. Otherwise, just leave her.
Well, that's like a date, which I don't mind doing.
It's like. Like a good idea would be like, oh, I have a ticket to this show, like this, or do you want to come to my comedy show? I'll pick you up and I'll take you to my comedy show.
That seems like too much.
Well,
I asked her about coffee and she didn't return my DM. So now the next step is to go, all right, if you're not going to return my DM on coffee, let me take it up a notch and invite you to a concert.
When Ooh. You run into her or something.
Or a dick pic. Send a dick pic.
No. When I first moved to LA, I met a comedian and he was like, hey, let me take you to one of my shows
right.
so that you can, you know, just know more about comedy. And I was like, okay. And he was like, it's not anything else. And then he picked me up and then I went to his show and then we went to get something to eat afterwards. And then on the way home, he tried to kiss me. And
was this a first date?
This was not supposed to be a date. This was
the first time together.
I'm just telling an example of a way that you could get her to kiss you by just like tricking her, like how it would happen.
I've been too forward with some girls. I've had girls refuse kisses from me.
Really?
Yeah, it's upsetting.
Yeah, I've. That's normal.
Bothers me. No, it doesn't bother me.
That's normal. It's better to try to kiss someone and get rejected than to never try to kiss someone.
That's like the worst feeling a guy could have.
Yeah.
Trying to kiss a girl and she turns her cheek.
Yeah.
Like, come on.
don't know.
I'm just trying to French kiss you.
French kiss. You start with like an American kiss and then move to the French kiss.
Right.
And
I've been too forward with some girls.
Like how?
Just.
See, I don't think there's nothing wrong, in my opinion, being forward with a girl. I'm overly forward with every girl I meet.
Yeah, you are.
And it's almost because that's who I am also. But I'm not being 100%
serious. You asked me to go to the Olive Garden with you after I met you for 5 minutes.
Did you? Well, I did. I posted that video today. I reposted that video, Lil Esther Tries Things.
Oh, yeah.
And it was just, I remembered how ridiculous that was, our first date. And we're just making movies and running around Universal.
It was our first date, but like.
We talked a couple times.
We had already.
Text back and forth
and had sex.
Oh yeah, we did that.
Really?
Did we have sex before that?
Yeah, that was like,
oh yeah, that's right, we had sex.
Can you
like
guys not
night.
Talk about sex with each other on this show?
Well, Esther was really easy, so
Esther, why Esther, why are you being so open about this stuff?
I'm not
now?
Being open, it's just that wasn't really our first date. We had already like been seeing each other for a while,
like a week, I think.
I don't know.
Remember, we met, and then that was 2 years ago, by the way, which seems ridiculous.
Yeah.
We met one night at the Improv, and then she went out of town for a week, and then we just
texted. I went out of town for a weekend.
Yeah, weekend, and then we just texted the whole time, and then when you came back, I think we fucked the immediately.
Will you not? I can't hear this kind of talk on this podcast. Esther, you started it, and but now it Brian's taking it to another level.
But it is true.
Why are you so open with who you're having
relations? Everyone knows that we dated.
But you never really talked about it in such.
She's got confidence now.
That's
it's
not
weird.
True.
I mean, such harsh descriptions.
He said the F word. I didn't.
I know, but you kind of like set it up for him.
No, I didn't. He's
the
one
I took
that
it.
Said
that's
that.
How I look at it.
What? Are you guys. No. It's just we were.
You've never spoken about your.
I don't.
Your
I haven't.
Relations.
I'm not supposed to speak about what's going on right now with me and Sprinkles. But Brian, hello.
We were just having like, yeah, we got really fast, and then we went on that date, and then it was like our relationship was more like playtime for 4 months or whatever
it
was.
We were playing house.
Yeah, we were playing house.
But I remember when I met you at the Improv, and then I had to leave. I left town the next morning,
mm-hmm.
and I saw my mom, and I'm like, I met a guy that I think is cute, and she was like, did he meet you? Like, she didn't believe that anyway.
What was my first... Was I creepy at the beginning, or what did
I
say?
I don't think Brody wants us to talk about that.
No, go ahead.
No,
I'm doing a text.
You were just like it was like a long night at the Naughty Show, and you like walked past me like 4 or 5 times, and then
act like I was on my cell phone.
Yeah, and then at one point, oh yeah, you were like, I really liked your video, and I was like, oh thanks, because that was my cool video premiered,
right.
And then. You did at one point. You were like, can I take you to the Olive Garden? And I was like...
did I really do that?
Yeah, absolutely.
I think I really did that in real life.
You absolutely said,
what?
I'll take you to... Let me take you. I'll take you to the Olive Garden. And then I was like, no.
Damn, that's my go-to.
And then Ari was there, and he told us to make out. And I was like, no.
Oh, he did, didn't he?
Did you go out with Ari also?
No, never.
Why not? Why do you say never like that?
Because you asked, like, maybe you thought that we did, but that we didn't. I've never gone out with Ari. Ari and I, we used to be friends, but now we don't really hang out anymore.
Because he's busy?
I think he thinks that he's better than me.
Really? Oh, honest. That's some... You think he's better... He thinks that he's better than
he
you?
He invited me to do his podcast, but I would have to talk about that I'm a drama queen. And I was like, no, I'm not doing that. He thinks I'm a drama queen.
I thought on his podcast you could talk about whatever you want.
Well, myth debunked.
Well, 17 retweets.
Of what?
The show.
Anyway.
Brody's kicking ass right now. You better
recognize. So now you're dating a new guy, and it's a black guy.
Are you talking to me or Brody?
Brody.
I'm right here. What's that?
No, so now Esther's dating a new guy.
I'm not dating a new guy.
Well, it seems like it.
I don't
Does
know.
Does he know that?
No.
How long you've known this guy?
I'm not dating anyone right now. I've been single for 6 months. I'm going to continue being single for a long time, probably. I talk to guys.
Do you have a booty call?
It's not a booty call. I have some people that I hang out with sometimes.
So multiple booty calls.
Okay. No, I'm not having sex.
You're not? That's good. So when your car's not there at night, I know you're not having sex. Esther, your car's not there. I'm surprised to see it there. But now that I know that you're not having sex and you're just making out and with you have sprinkles with you, I'm okay with that. That's what you learn when you don't do shows for a while. You learn about sprinkles. You learn about open sex talk. You've grown up a lot in the last couple months, apparently.
Since the last podcast, both of you have grown up a lot.
I don't know if me carrying around a stuffed animal indicates I've grown up. And then I'm That's just true. Kissing. But no, you're right.
You're more confident.
You are.
I can see it.
You know what it is from?
Ballet.
No.
Working out?
It's probably from working out, but also I have a new best friend that I'm really excited about.
Sprinkles.
Him and...
Your friend, that girlfriend that came in.
Who?
Is it a girl or a guy?
A girl. Who are you thinking?
The girl that just moved here that or something
no,
like that?
No, it's actually... Brie Olson.
Oh, Brie Olson. Yeah.
So that's why you're confident all of a sudden?
Because I don't know. I'm just saying. I'm not confident all of a sudden. I'm just like.
You're burping into the microphone.
I always do that,
I've
Brody.
Never seen it.
Maybe she's just been hanging out with Christina Pajitsky lately.
She burps into the mic.
Yeah, she does that a lot and farts in the microphone.
I don't do that, but I burp.
I used to fart into the mic. Not here, but on my cable access show. The fart mic we had. I used to do that quite a bit.
Really? Was your diet changed since then? Or
I ate a lot of pizza back then.
No, that's it.
Do you think once I get back into the gym, I'll feel better? That will get some things going too? Like just overall, my body, my flexibility?
I think probably. I mean, that's what people tell me that I need to do. But
get
I just,
into the gym.
I just don't have any motivation to do that.
But you know what? I'll say this because I'm not saying that I'm now all changed into being a gym person because I never will. Like I'm always either... doing it or not doing it, like it's always changing, but there's a way to just slowly, little by little, get yourself there. Like if you just start slow.
Yeah, I've been paying for a membership for a year. That's my first start.
Like walk to Taco Bell. Like that's a, you know, give yourself presents and incentives.
I walk every day to Starbucks.
What do you get at Starbucks these days?
Trenta iced coffee, unsweetened with 4 Splendas and then a little bit of half and half.
Wait, that's similar to what I do.
Trenta iced coffee.
I do a venti. I did a venti iced sweetened with a little half and half.
Don't do the sweetener.
Why? Because that's
it's
sissy?
Like, it's really, it's got a lot of calories.
You do
or
Splenda
sugar.
Instead?
I do Splenda instead, which will give me brain cancer. But my ideal thing is just get it unsweetened, little half and half, go home, put some stevia in it. Stevia is the best, I think.
Oh, yeah, that's very
What's
true.
Stevia?
It's a natural sweetener.
And they need to get that at Starbucks.
Yeah, they do. But I think everyone will steal it. Or it's more expensive. I think is why they don't do it. But
I've seen it at some places, though. Mm-hmm. Smaller places.
Is Splenda really that bad for you?
Well, what my dad has been saying for like 15 years is that your brain thinks it's sugar. So your brain is going to put out like the, hey, Brian just ate sugar. Go fucking get rid of that shit. And then when it goes to get it, there's no sugar. So it just like it fucks with. Like it fucks with your body is what my dad's saying. I forget what the actual things that he says, but he's like a Splenda. He hates Splenda. He's been against Splenda since it came out.
Sweet and low, same idea.
I like thinking about little cells in your brain that are like, Brian, no, and they're yelling at you, and you kill
Should you
them.
Just use regular sugar, or that's just fattening?
No, I don't use regular sugar, but it's probably healthier for you to use regular sugar than it is Splenda.
It's hard. I mean, they're all bad. I don't know. I've got problems, too.
Like when I get my refill at Coffee Bean, the first one I get.
You get refills at Coffee Bean?
What the?
Yeah. You don't get them there? You
no,
don't know about that?
I only get refills at Starbucks.
You can get it's $1 for a refill at Coffee Bean.
Well, they're 50 cents at Starbucks.
They're 50 cents. But the iced coffee that I get.
You can't refill that, can you?
Yeah.
How much is it?
$1.
At Starbucks?
Do you get refills? Brian, do you get refills at Starbucks?
This Trenta destroys me. I start having heart palpitations after this and stuff. So this is fine.
How long does that last?
This coffee, I usually get around noon average, and it lasts till like 4 o'clock. And then I don't get hungry because I all the caffeine. So then I usually eat around 8 o'clock at night. And I have the worst diet ever, so.
Well.
Do you think you're healthy, Brian?
No. I'm so unhealthy, it's retarded.
Does Rogan get on you for not being healthy?
I love talking about this. Tell us more about it.
No, I'm so unhealthy. I eat fucking Lean Pockets every day. I've had
Lean Pockets.
When I'm single, it's like, I need to eat. Oh, I got a Lean Pocket. I'll eat that. You know, like, I'm the worst person for health.
Why is that when you're single, you're not eating properly?
Because he doesn't have a lady to take out.
Well, one is that I have no appetite because of this Trent iced coffee.
Okay.
The other thing is I'm really basic. Like, yeah, I like steaks and stuff. But unless I go out to eat every single day and I'm at home, it's like I'll go to the grocery store and buy 4 boxes of Lean Pockets, some sandwich meat, some bread and some cheese. And I'll just have sandwiches every day and Lean Pockets every day. Like the most boring thing in the world because I don't care. Like, I have to eat just because I
have
to.
What about like canned tuna or something? Isn't that healthy? Or almonds?
Yeah, I guess, but that, I don't know. I'm just not.
He's like if a 9-year-old boy got a credit card.
Do you have cereal?
I sometimes have cereal with almond milk, but even that's too much. You know, like I'll have one bowl.
Yeah, it's too much dishes.
Yeah, dishes. I don't have a dishwasher, so it's like I need my shit microwaved or
hire a dishwasher.
I can. It's racist.
I love grape nuts. I'm just trying to get comfortable. I love grape nuts.
Yeah.
That's a good meal. I know when I'm eating grapes. What about bananas?
I do eat bananas.
Okay, that's good. What about apples?
No.
Why not?
Because I have 2 fake front teeth, and then I've been scared of apples for
okay.
a while.
Okay, that's fair enough. But you know, what about protein shakes?
Too much dishes.
Really? You won't do a protein? Esther, stop it. That is really unladylike, and it bothers me.
I'm sorry.
So what about protein shakes?
Too much dishes. I mean, I have
a Vitamix that he doesn't use.
That I used to use a lot when I had a girlfriend for some reason. Because I think when I have a girlfriend, I stay home more. You know, so if I use the Vitamix, I'm home, so I'll clean it and I'll cook more or I'll eat better when I have a girlfriend because I'm at home all the time. But when I'm single, I'm like, all right, I need to go to a comedy club. I need to try to get up on stage. I I'm always out. I don't want to be at home sitting by myself at home with my fucking animals. I want to be out, you know, feeling like I'm...
I like seeing you out.
Yeah.
It's always a nice touch to have you at the comedy store.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, the problem now is I feel like I'm there every day, you know?
And I rarely see you there.
I'm there every day. Every single day.
Why do you like the comedy store so much?
Because like all my friends are there, yeah. You know, like Tony Hinchcliffe, you know, and all those guys. So
yeah, I'm not like I'm sure that's the reason why.
Right.
But is it the vibe there you like?
Yeah, it's the people. I mean, if all those people hung out at a bowling alley, I'd be at the bowling alley every day. Like, because unfortunately, I don't get to go up at the comedy store much because I'm just not in that group yet that can go up anytime they want to. But it's still something about hanging out with everybody there. I'd rather do that than go to a bar that I don't know anybody at, you know, or go to wherever. It's like, oh, wait, there's a place where all my friends are at right now. It's like having a party every day, kind of.
You know, people don't realize the comedy store, if you hang out there compared to like a nightclub or, you know, a bar, you're going to see more people doing, like, I'm not going to say celebrities, but you're going to see... There's probably more influence at a comedy club than there is at a bar.
Yeah.
In terms of people doing stuff. You're going to find more interesting characters.
Absolutely. Like absolutely.
Comedians are interesting.
There's always stuff going on there.
And the people, there's always stuff going on. And then you never know who's going to drop in due time. It's like a comedy club is kind of cool.
Yeah.
You know, to hang out at if you're not a comedian.
Agreed.
Would you say so?
I think... I don't ever go out to bars. I would never go to a nightclub. But a comedy club, it's so fun, especially the comedy store. There's so many places to hang out. And when you're sick of talking to people, you can just go sit down and watch comedy.
Yeah.
So it's a great... There's a front patio. There's a back. There's places to hang out inside. There's a bar. There's just so much going on. But the problem is that you get sucked in, and then you hang out there like till 3 a.m.
Yeah.
And then you get forced into going to IHOP and, you know...
Yeah. Yeah, it's definitely, it's not healthy.
What's not healthy about it?
Being addicted to the comedy store every day, I don't think that's healthy because I find myself, you know, going there every day, I tried to drink every other day,
uh-huh.
but you know, I'll go there, I'll drink, hang out till 2 or 3 in the morning. Then it's like, hey, everyone's getting food. You know, then you're out till 5 in the morning. You're waking up at 1, and you know, it's just, it's a trap that you can get into easily. I'm just saying, if you're going out in LA or if you're going out in your hometown, instead of going to a bar where you can't hear anybody talk and you don't know anybody there, if you just go to start hanging out at a comedy club, it's like hanging out at a clubhouse.
Yeah,
it's and a you're clubhouse. Gonna and after a while of hanging there, you're gonna know everybody there. There's people that hang out there that aren't comics that just hang out there to drink and hang out every night, and now they're pretty much accepted by the comics as just, you know, whatever. You know what I'm talking about?
Oh yeah, I think the Comedy Store, what you said is right. You can get sucked in to staying up late. It's because you're having a good time.
Yeah.
Usually.
It's not boring.
Right. It's not boring.
Because you can always change it up and go to a different room and there's different people.
You know, for me, I got to watch it with the pot. You know, the people are smoking pot. Not that it's a drug den, but I have to be, you know, careful with that.
There's a lot of marijuana going on.
Oh, and there's also like no one controlling anything. So it's just like there's no rules.
Yeah, there's no rules, which is nice.
It's an honor code.
The honor system.
I mean, my thing is, if I do smoke pot and I do smoke it there, at least I'm in a supportive environment. I'll tell a comedian or two, goes, guys, I smoke pot. I shouldn't have. I'm paranoid. Stay with me.
Right.
And I only say that because
with me.
Stay with me. Only because I'm on I'm on meds and nobody wants to talk about it anymore. So I'm just gonna have to keep it in and talk to my psychiatrist.
Brody.
My psychiatrist.
You don't have to keep it in, but it's like we can, you know, explore other topics.
I agree with you, Esther. But I was also explaining why I'm feeling good.
Yeah, which
why,
is great.
Why has my comedy been better?
Because you've found the right mix, and we're all happy to hear that.
Well, I haven't found the right mix yet, but I know one particular medication is helping me stay in a good zone. Because I can intimidate an audience. I can get into a red zone. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So if I'm on this mood stabilizer, like you see me today doing this podcast. I mean, Brian would tell you that my comedy now, like compared to my first couple podcasts when I was screaming and yelling.
Yeah.
Doing all that stuff. You were there. That was the old Brody. Was it funny to some people?
Yeah.
But
it was a lot though. Like I had to take intermissions and stuff.
Right. I've learned that podcasting now, in general, is like, this is the way to do it. My strength is just talking, being like this.
Yeah.
Not doing shtick, not performing, you know, maybe throwing a few enjoy. It's like, if this were my, you know, a Brode show, just Brode alone, I would do an opening monologue where I'm like amped up and doing all that, and then I would mellow down. But, you know, Brode, Esther, you got Brian here. It's just conversation. That's what people want to hear. They want to hear three real people talk about life, talk about late night escapades, whether it involves a Comedy Store or something else.
Yeah, and sprinkles and food and Brian being unhealthy.
Mm. Is there a Hangover 3, Brody?
Yeah, they're shooting it right now.
Are you in it?
As of today, no, I'm not in it.
You have to be in it.
I'm not in it, and I'd like to be in it. Zach is telling me that I could be in it, but no guarantees. I think they're shooting up there for 3 weeks. If you ask me, I would like to be in it, of course. But if I'm not in it, it's not going to devastate me. I'm happy that I was in the first two. And some guys are in one, weren't in two.
You were unsure of being in the second one, though, if I recall.
That too, yeah.
So it was last minute for the second one.
Kind of, yeah. So that could happen with this.
Yeah.
So again, I'd like to do it. I'm ready to do it. And there may or may not be a role for me. So it all depends. You know, if there's a role for me, they're thinking about me. And I want you Death Squatters to think about me too, you know. Say a little prayer tonight that you'd like to see Brody in Hangover 3. I would like to see myself in Hangover 3. It would help my confidence.
Say a little prayer for Brody. You. Whenever you stay in my heart and always. See, we love you, Brody.
But, you know, the other night when I did 55, no, I did an hour and five, hour and 10.
Hour and 10.
I did an hour and 10 minutes in the main room. And my thing is when I do the main room, that last spot, that Sam Kinison spot, I like to call it, I just want to keep the audience, whether it's anywhere from 10 people to 30 people. We had about 30 people in there, maybe.
And you kept them all. They just got done saying so much comedy, and then you just, at the end, just did like 75% more time than all the other comics combined, almost.
Yeah.
And then you kept every single person there, and every person was just glued
enjoying it.
Enjoying it.
Brian,
it
the awesome. Smoking is reminding me of my grandma.
All right.
My grandma smoked.
Yeah, same.
My dad smoked, too, till he had a heart attack. Then he stopped.
And the zombies are scary.
Little Esther zombie? You don't like Little Esther zombie?
I know you guys call it that.
Little Esther, she died of, looks like, sliced in the throat.
But doing the doing that main room, it was like a good feeling to do it. And to...
Yeah.
Get laughs, you know?
I like when you reenact the hangover scene. That's one of my favorite parts when you do that reaction.
They all want to hear it. I always ask the audience, who wants me to hear the line? They all go nuts, so I do it. And then they know who I am in the movie. That's, you know, helps out. But yeah, when I do the main room, when I have that last spot, they've seen, 2 hours of comedy. They've seen Bobby Lee, Chris D'Elia, Don Marrera, Mark Maron, all these guys, great comedians. And then they see me, and I just try to keep them.
And you do?
I do. I have been able to keep them. I've been pretty good with that. And I've done anywhere from, I usually do 45 to an hour. And it's good practice. It gives me confidence that I can go out on the road and do 45 to an hour with crowd work. I have to do crowd work, mix in some new jokes. I'm not going to be hard on myself. What do you feel like, Esther, when you do the Comedy Store? What goes through your mind?
Get me out of here.
Really?
No. I love the Comedy Store. I like going there, and I don't really hang out there as much anymore. But I like going, and... Whenever I go there, I usually end up, my night will change. Like, I will have a plan, and I will be trying to stick to that plan, and then something will happen at the Comedy Store, and then it changes. Like, last weekend, Bobby Lee was like, come to this party, and then I went to this party, but I didn't get
in. Was it a good party?
I was too ugly. No, I didn't get in.
Why not?
Because it's a nightclub, and I was dressed like a little boy.
Why did he want to go there?
It was actually it was somebody's birthday party, and
somebody famous, or were there celebrities going to be there?
I think there were some celebrities there, and then
just curious.
Yeah, and then there was the one night I was at the Comedy Store, and I did my set, and then I went to Taco Bell, and then I went back to the Comedy Store, and it was got to be 4 a.m. and we're in the parking lot, and Brian made me go to IHOP with him. And
after you ate Taco Bell,
yeah,
you went to IHOP.
Yeah, with Brian, Benji, and Tony, and...
We did that?
Yeah, you guys made me eat.
Here's a little Esther at a party. Remember we went to a party
yeah.
once, and there was...
Whoa, there's your bra.
I'm wearing this.
What?
Look how skinny you are.
Oh, thank you.
So what?
Thank you so much. That means I'm fat now.
That was a fun party.
It was.
We pretty much acted like kids at this party.
The Hilton sisters were there.
That's right, and there was a live tiger there also.
So you were filming this?
Yeah.
Nice job, Brian.
Well, this part's not real. But... And this is at the party. We made peanut butter and jelly sandwiches while all these high-class celebrities were... talking.
I got the dirtiest look.
And then she ate it on the toilet, her little peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
It was a peanut butter and jelly tortilla.
Yeah.
Your videos are funny, Brian.
Our videos together are really good. We should make another one.
Yeah. We should start dating again for... And look at this tiger. They have a tiger just at this party, which I thought was weird.
I pet it. It looks so creepy.
Oh, you're pet the tiger?
Yeah, you got to pet the tiger. And then we tried to go outside and mingle, but we're like just... It was really dumb. Like,
how did you get into this party?
This feels like it was recent, but I know it was.
Who's that guy?
That's Nick Youssef.
Nick Youssef.
He was at the party?
Yep. And then she just kind of just laid down in the middle of the party and went to sleep. Really weird. But yeah.
That was funny.
Thanks, Brody.
You spit all over the mic.
That was at Benji's old house.
Oh, that's where it was?
It was his brother's party.
Yeah.
His brother is like a cool Hollywood guy. Way cooler than Benji. Benji's the loser. JK.
Just kidding.
Mm-hmm. I think I say bad things about the people I like, and then I get texts from Carlos. He's like, you called me gay on a podcast.
He's listening?
I guess. I don't know.
We should say something about
I'm
Carlos.
I'm sure someone told him. No, I'm sure he's not listening. Someone probably just told him that I said he was gay on the podcast, which is fine. I don't really care. Carlos, I know you're not gay, okay?
Carlos has gone through a transformation from since when I first met him. I remember meeting him at Sal's back in the day, and now you know he's just like working out. He's all, you know, tucking in his t-shirts, and you know he's looking good.
Like, I go hiking with him.
Yeah,
he's a good hike partner.
Yeah, Carlos is great.
Carlos is not gay. Esther,
Brian, do you like? I can ask both of you guys. Do you guys like Twitter? Is it still fun for you?
Or
is it stressful at all?
I like Twitter. It's not stressful, but I think that I like Instagram more as a girl.
Just the pictures you take?
I like pictures. I like searching hashtags on Instagram. Like, sometimes I'll search for Fitspiration, like, which is like girls who work out a lot.
Uh-huh.
And then I look at their pictures. I like that.
Fitspiration, that's a real hashtag?
Yeah.
And so if you're in good shape and you're a girl, you put that hashtag.
And then, yeah, exactly.
So there's a whole another world of Instagram that I'm not even into.
Exactly.
I think Instagram's cool. I mean, I hated it for the longest time, and then everyone's like, you have to use Instagram. So now that I play with it.
You're good at it. I like that you do it now.
It's okay. But I think Twitter, I still check it a lot, I have found myself not doing it as much lately. Because I feel like it's a time sucker, waster, you know, like I feel like I'm like on it like crack. So I've kind of taken that down a notch. Facebook, I'm almost not on at all anymore.
I actually stopped Facebook cold turkey for like almost maybe 6 months, but then I brought it back and now I'm on Facebook a lot.
I stopped Lexapro cold turkey and I had a manic episode.
Oh, yeah, true.
Relatable,
but they also threw an antibiotic into it.
Hmm.
Nobody wants to talk about that anymore.
I actually have to go potty. I'll be right back.
Just go right here.
Give her a Dixie cup.
Yeah. Go in my Starbucks cup, Trenta.
So, Brian, would you say that this kind of podcast we doing today I think it's a pretty good one.
Yeah, I think people love Broden and Esther because it's kind of relaxing.
This is a relaxing podcast.
Yeah.
I don't do a monologue up front.
Right.
We're not arguing. We're joking around.
It's weird also seeing how you guys change every time we do it. Like look at little Esther today. That's completely different Esther. Wouldn't you say?
Yeah.
You think that's confidence with her new boyfriend that she has and she doesn't want to talk about?
It could be.
Yeah, I think it is. Confidence.
You know, you get confidence and you get keep doing it. You grow. You know, doing those spots at the Comedy Store make you a better comedian. Not doing the spots here at the Ice House. Those are good too.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but the more you do it, hopefully you get better and more confident. Just like I did an hour and 10 minutes the other night.
Right.
That gave me a little jolt of confidence.
I'm at the Irvine Improv tonight. Have you ever done the comedy juice?
Yeah, I did it last week.
How'd it go?
Oh, I met a girl after the show.
Oh, that's cool. That's right. So you stay for the whole thing?
Both of them. Sometimes I close the first show. I did a half hour. I did okay. It was only about...
That's a different improv, right? Like you...
Irvine Improv.
They're both, so they have two shows back to back, 8 and 10?
They did, and they may stop doing that.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know tonight if it's just one show or two shows.
I think it's two shows, but I think I'm only on the 10 o'clock show.
Yeah, some people he switched up. I drove down with him, so he threw me on to headline the first show, and there was only like 40, 50 people in the audience, maybe.
Second show better?
Second show better. It was like more people, younger people, and that was to be expected. The 10 o'clock show is usually a little more crowded. And that one I went on in the middle and I did about a half hour too and I had fun.
Oh, wow.
And I always struggle down in Irvine. It's just a mental thing with me and I feel like I just don't connect with them.
Me too.
But I said, you know what? I'm going to do a couple jokes up front, then I'll do the crowd work and then I'll work in some other jokes. You know, some comedians would say like, Brody, you're doing crowd work. That's, that's a crutch or whatever. Or you can't do that on TV. But it's helping me right now. It's like what I need to do. Sometimes you got to be up there with training wheels a little bit. Maybe I need to, it's like batting off a tee, you know, okay, I need to do a little crowd work so I can get comfortable up there and practice my swing. If I'm just up there with no crowd work and straight material, my strength is my likability. So if I can get my likability across in crowd work, so be it. Eventually down the road, I don't want to be able to not have to rely on crowd work.
Right.
You know, because
But you have a unique kind of crowd work, almost.
Yeah.
You're not like a regular crowd work guy.
No, I have a unique crowd work. But again, how can you do that on TV, number one? And then, yeah, somebody who's not as bright as you is just going to say he's you know, they're going to say, okay, he's doing crowd work, but they want jokes. A lot of comedians respect jokes and material.
Well, I got in a fight with a guy, not a fight, I guess, an argument with a guy just last weekend in Minneapolis. After the show, we went to go see Arch Barker down the street.
Right.
And hanging out with one of the opening one of the guys that opened up for him at the bar. And I've never met the guy before, but I was talking about how I don't like following guys that are just crowd work. You know, like just crowd work. Because usually it makes them talk. You know, the audience tries to talk to you then when you're on stage, you know. And if you're not a crowd work comic, then you have all these people talking to you and you're like, hey, you know, calm down. I don't, you know, it kind of fucks with the next comic sometimes if it's 100% crowd work. And so I was telling this guy that and he just got really, really upset at me. And I guess he was a crowd work comic. I didn't know. And I think he felt like I was disrespecting him. Like I knew that, but I didn't know. And I was like trying to tell him, like, no, like, look, if I buy a ticket to a comedy show to go see comics, I kind of think that in my head I would imagine like, oh, I'm going to see almost like a play, or this comic has taken like made a set or like a show. And I think if you're paying for a ticket and you just go and it's kind of like just like, hey, it's like, you know, people talking to, you know, and the audience, like, how old are you? Where are you guys from? You know, and stuff like that. I consider that something like if you're at Universal Studios or something
like that. But I do that.
You don't do it
in the same way. So I'm upset now.
No, you don't do it in the same way because you have material and then at parts you talk to the audience, which is always funny though.
Right.
And what I don't like though is there's some comics that they don't have material, their whole thing is crowd work. That's what I was trying to say. And those people are hard to follow because they get the audience talkative.
I mean, I could see that.
Yeah.
I mean, I never thought about that, you know, about the next guy. But that's part of it, you know, you got to like get the audience to be quiet. Sometimes it's hard to follow certain guys. Yeah.
Yeah. Like, I recently followed somebody. I don't want to say who it was. I recently followed somebody. And when I got on stage, the guy had, you know, talked to the audience for his whole set. And when I got on stage, it was me trying to do my material while people were yelling things at me. And I'm like, hey, that's funny. All right, calm down. All right. And I kept on I was having to do extra work just to shut them up now, you know, where because they now think this is an interactive show. And...
Well, in the long run, it's going to make you a stronger comedian.
Yeah.
Because you have to deal with that.
Yeah. But what I was trying to tell this guy last week is that I just prefer not following crowd work guys, you know?
Well, me personally, I don't want to follow crowd work guys because I do some crowd work.
Right.
So it's like, oh, you're going to touch on this.
Yeah, but there's a difference between you just doing some crowd work and then that's your whole shit. You know, you have fucking material.
I think that I'm just going to be honest.
Within my crowd work.
Yeah. I'm going to be honest. I think this conversation is boring.
Hey, Esther, why would you say that? You were is that Clif Bar that you just had that gave you
more confidence from a Clif Bar?
Is that the negative energy flavor?
I don't know. I was just being honest. I wasn't trying to judge you. I didn't want to participate.
If you ask me right now, do I think this is one of our better podcasts? I'm going to say yes.
I agree.
Because we both have grown.
Yes.
I'm in a good place today because I saw apartments.
I'm in a good place today because I hung out with Bree Olson, my idol.
You hung out with Bree Olson. You did it at her house?
We did a podcast at her house.
Does she have a nice house?
She does, but today we went grocery shopping.
Oh, you just went grocery shopping with Bree?
You didn't do that as part of a podcast? It was just a regular grocery shopping trip?
Yeah, we just...
I used to talk to Bree back and forth. She was supposed to come do Triple X Squad, one of the podcasts we do here. But then she got a new phone number and... I didn't know how long she had the new phone number. So I've been texting this person for a while. And finally the person was just like, look, all right, I don't know who this person is. I got a new number. Please stop texting me. I'm like, oh, yeesh. I hate when people do that. There should be a way to, because I got a new phone number recently. And now this guy that had my number before, Daniel, all these people are calling him, leaving threatening messages because he's not paying his child support and shit. There should be like a way to like go, hey, look, every single person that's trying to call and attack Daniel.
What if you're Daniel anymore. And you owe child support?
Like if it's like a Fight Club thing this whole time, I have it like,
I didn't see that
I'm
movie.
Daniel.
Daniel's not paying child support?
No. And you want to hear like some threatening message? Like, listen,
yeah,
how.
Yeah, I do.
And this is not really a threatening message, but this is like, look how, listen to the tone of like what happens when you don't pay child support. Let's see if I can play this.
We're waiting for.
This is an urgent message from the Los Angeles County Child Support Services Department about your child support. We have not received a recent payment from you. This is a reminder that you must make your support payments every month to avoid added interest, arrears, and other serious consequences. If you have any questions or if you would like to...
But it's just like, listen, the tone isn't just like, hey, this is so-and-so from, you know, the child support. This is like, you must make a payment every month. Like,
that scared me.
Yeah.
No, it scared me too. That's why I
don't want to have babies.
That's why I think that Mitt Romney's a loser because he doesn't like abortions.
Yeah, I retweeted that. I agree with that.
Thank you.
That alone scares the fuck out of me. Imagine if you could not get an abortion. That's stupid.
It's insane. And I don't think it'll ever happen, but I just think it's a crazy thought.
You can still get an abortion in this country, right? Just certain states?
Right now, yeah.
But
you can get it here in California.
And he doesn't want abortions, period.
I think that's what he's saying. No
he's
abortions.
He's a Mormon. Yeah, I think most Republicans, like, they don't like him. I think it would take a... I don't know anything about politics. I mean, I'm just the worst, but I think that that's, like, what he wants, and that's a part of his campaign, is that he doesn't think that abortions are okay.
What happens if a Republican guy said was okay with abortion, like, I'm pro-choice? Would some of those people who are Democrats that were going to vote for the Democrats switch over?
I don't know if abortion is the number one issue that's keeping them from being Republican, but maybe if it is for that person. Usually it's like a finance thing. Or
do you think the president, it matters that much these days?
I'll say this. I don't know if it matters, but I know that it doesn't matter what I know or care, because I just don't. I think that voting is important. I get it, whatever, but I don't know.
Are you going to vote?
No, I'm not.
I think it's
a waste of time.
I'm kind of disenfranchised.
What does that mean?
Meaning I don't want to vote.
Yeah, I don't care. I don't want to put time and energy into, like, thinking about it and which can't. Because I think that after what happened in that one election where they cheated us, that it's over, bro. Like, they lost their chance at me caring, which I know is... sounds really dumb because I'm the one that loses on it, but I think it's a waste of time. I'm sorry.
Did you think the debates would be so popular? I mean, I guess it's kind of neat, but how popular the debates are on Twitter, for example, just everybody involved throwing out, you know, comedy, and they're funny, they're saying funny stuff, but it's just like, you know, debates, were they ever this popular? Or is it because,
well,
like,
social media heightens that, their popularity?
Yeah.
Because it's like a place for us all to talk about it easily.
Right. I mean, social media has changed, has really affected a lot of things.
I saw Sarah Palin at the Dancing with the Stars taping.
Oh, really? Because her daughter's on it?
Yeah, she looked cute.
Sarah Palin or her daughter?
Sarah Palin.
I guess both.
Did she have security around her?
No, but she was wearing... Sarah Palin had sort of an attitude, I feel, and then Bristol Palin was kind of just like, hey, I'm here. She was more, like, friendly, approachable.
How close did you get to Sarah Palin?
Like, standing close to her. It wasn't, like, a big deal.
She looks good, though, in person?
She looks okay. She looks okay.
People love attacking her.
Yeah, they do. I think that's
funny. But she asked for it.
I heard Sarah Palin's all methed out looking now.
Yeah, she lost a lot of weight, and I've heard a rumor that she wants to do like a diet book or something ridiculous.
She had a TV show. Ugh. Didn't they have a show up there? Growing up Palin or something?
Oh, yeah.
Something
Nobody
like that.
Nobody cared.
Yeah.
This politics, I don't get into it. It's just too much mudslinging. It's just too... But it's very, you know, Twitter is a liberal forum, wouldn't you say? Like,
yeah, there's definitely probably.
I mean, the funniest tweets are done by comedians, generally. And generally, most comedians are liberal.
Is Mitt Romney Mormon?
Yes.
Yeah.
Is that like, does he have a lot of wives or something?
I don't think so.
Does he make other women like build stuff for him?
I honestly have not been paying any attention to anybody.
Oh, cool. We're on the same page then. Yeah.
For the last few minutes or the elections?
Elections.
Why not?
Because I don't care about either of them. Like it seems like most of the time, it's always been like, okay, this guy definitely is better than this guy. You know, at least for me, it's always been kind of that way. This time, it just seems like, why even bother? Just let Obama just stay in the office because all you guys that are running against him just suck, and Obama sucks, and you know, like the person I wanted was
Ron Paul.
Roseanne Ron Paul. Barr.
Yeah, or Roseanne. I would take either of those
Ron
people.
Paul or Roseanne. Yeah, of course.
But but that's not going to happen. So it's like, why even bother voting for Ron Paul? Because that's not going to happen. Everyone knows that's not going to happen. My mom even usually votes every year. And this time she's like, I just want to vote for Perot. And I'm like, what? Perot's not even... Is he even alive? You know, but...
I think he's still alive.
Is he?
I think so.
Yeah, it's a lost cause. I know that sounds really negative, and I'm sorry, but it's... You know,
it's just
I thought that, you know, comedians, there weren't political comedians, but on Twitter, they're political comedians. They're funny.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's just not, you don't hear much of it on stage. It's save for Twitter. But I feel like I'm left out. Everyone watching these, you know, the debates, it makes me feel like I'm not a part of school pride or something like that. You know, when I played baseball, we didn't follow politics. You know, but it seems like everybody's following politics. At least everybody I follow on Twitter. I mean,
there's a lot of people. Yeah,
so many debate tweets. I mean, I guess that's good that we care about the government. But I'm not as passionate about that. I'm not passionate about a lot of things. I'm trying to be more passionate about myself.
I agree.
You know, it's like maybe I got to take a year off from these elections.
Yeah, 4 years off.
Yeah, the last election, the last election day, I was in college, and I was going to vote. I'll tell you what happened, okay? I'm a little scarred. I went to the voting poll, or whatever it's called, and I tried to vote, and they told me, no, you can't vote because you're not registered in this town. Because I was registered where I grew up and not in my college town. And I was like, are you fucking kidding me? And they're like, no, we're not fucking kidding. And I had to not vote after I went all the way across campus to vote. And I was
across campus.
And I was so pissed off that... I went to this little place called the Cookie Jar and got like 4 cookies and ate them. And then I ditched my internship at the news station. And shortly after, I dropped out of college.
Wow, that just sent a downward spiral for you, that walk across campus.
Yeah, the unnecessary walk across campus. It did. It really, it.
That got the ball rolling.
Yeah.
So you brought that negative energy. You can't vote.
Yeah, they were like, you can't vote. And I was like, is it because I'm a woman? And they were like, no. And I was like, is it because I'm a Jew? And they were like, no, it's because you're not registered. You made a mistake.
And then that upset you.
Yeah. So
you threatened them with the Judaism line.
Yeah.
You pulled that card.
Yeah, and the woman card. And maybe I've said something about my face looking young.
Yeah, my face looking young.
And then that was it.
And then you went to the cookie place.
The cookie jar.
And then you lied down somewhere?
No, I was at my computer.
And then you said...
I think I was watching The Office online illegally.
And you said you blew off your internship for that night?
Yeah, I was like, fuck the news station. Oh, sorry. I was like...
You were really cursing a lot. You're burping, you're cursing.
You cursed.
No, bars. I didn't.
You cursed the last podcast. And
maybe I did.
Yeah, and I said, Brody, don't curse. And you were like, we curse now.
Oh, I did.
Yeah.
All right. Good memory.
But yeah, I ate the cookies. And then even though it was election day, I didn't go to my internship at the news station.
And that was one of their busiest days of the year. They needed you.
Yeah. I hope my parents aren't listening to this.
So did you...
It was cold.
Yeah. It was in November. Yeah. Did you return back to the internship eventually?
I didn't. That was it.
That was it.
Yeah. That was it.
She took off on the busiest day of the year, left us hanging.
Yeah.
Wow. And then you dropped out of school time after that.
3 or 4 months later, yeah.
But you know, we're better as a world or as a country and as a comedy community having you comedy right now. You do a great job at Comedy Store. I love seeing your name up there. Do you get nervous going up into a packed OR?
Yeah.
What do you get nervous about?
Sometimes I get just nervous that... well, if it doesn't go well, who's there, stuff like that.
What about if there's 30 people in there? Do you still get those same kind of nerves?
Sometimes. yeah, sometimes it just depends. It doesn't, I actually think it has less to do with how many people are there and just how I'm feeling, how confident I'm feeling. If I'm feeling confident, there could be any number in there and I'm fine. But sometimes I'm like, oh, I haven't done comedy in a week or something like that. I'm scared or I'm trying new stuff, you know.
If you throw me up in front of a packed original room, it's like you're, there's a lot of energy in there. And I think it takes a few times to get used to it. I think if you're yeah. So for me, I've been there 10 years or so. Most of my sets, most of them take place after the hump, meaning like the crowd's, it's on the downward side.
Yeah. It's really difficult.
Right. Well, I get a lot at the Comedy Store. I'm not saying I get bad spots, but I usually get, I'm not getting the prime time spots. I'm okay with that. I'm happy with that. I get 2 to 3 spots. And I like going up last in the main room. But if you were to put me up in the main room at the height of the main room and to put me up in the original room at the height of the show, I would probably need, you know, four to five of those sets to get comfortable, like to know that doesn't matter how you do, Brody, I'm putting you up there tomorrow night too. And it doesn't matter how you do, I'm putting you up there the next weekend. That doesn't happen. So right. You like do one of those spots and it's a bad experience.
You're scared, yeah.
And then you don't get another one. Even if you'd crushed, you may not get another one.
Yeah, there's really no method to any of it except for, well, I don't know.
You know, but it's the same thing at the Laugh Factory. You know, packed room in there. I it makes me, you know, not feel confident. I feel like, oh, they're not going to get me. Whereas a packed improv on Melrose, I'm far more comfortable. For some reason, the Melrose Improv, I can go in there in a packed showroom and do well and be myself.
What if Mitt Romney came to one of our shows and he was really nice? Then what do?
You still don't vote for him.
Yeah, it's just say, hey, he was nice.
But Paul Ryan is so handsome.
Is he really?
He's very handsome.
Is that the vice president?
Yeah. Republicans don't even know that. Love good-looking VPs.
I didn't even know that.
Dan Quayle was a fox.
The presidential shit's like the same to me as sports.
Oh, yeah. No, it is for me, too. This is, I mean...
Brian, you don't follow sports at all?
No. You know, when we had that guy, that testosterone guy on the other day...
And Joe Rogan? I'm kidding.
On the Joe Rogan podcast. No.
Joking.
On the Joe Rogan podcast. But he was telling us, like, how, you know, like, yeah, you know how Lance Armstrong, everyone was like, oh, Lance Armstrong's the best biker in the world. But you find out, you know, he's pumped up on juice, so now they take away all his medals and stuff. But this guy was telling us, like, how, yeah, like every single, you know, athletes on, you know, like the tennis players are on it, the boxers are on it. And so it's just, you know, it took a sport that's, you know, in my opinion, it's just fake. You don't know who's on what and who's, you know, it's not fair. You have to have an even playing field for it to be an even match. And
that's why you're not into sports?
Well, I think I was not into sports just because I didn't grow up with sports. Because I live from Columbus, Ohio, we didn't have a professional team. I grew up with the Buckeyes. I'm a Buckeye fan. Like, if the Buckeye game's on, I'll watch that. But when it comes to, like, baseball or basketball or any of the other stuff, I didn't grow up around it. So it just never interested me. But now, you know, just knowing things like that, it's like, why do I even want to watch that? It's
well, let me ask you, because for a year, I haven't really been following sports like I should. Since I've moved to my studio apartment. And even before that, I wasn't on top of sports like I used to be. What do you fill your time with? Or is that something I should feel bad about that?
Well, no. See, I think if you enjoy sports, that's fine. There's nothing, whatever.
But no, there's
I
don't nothing think, wrong with it.
But I think people are so passionate about it. And I think, honestly, it's a tremendous waste of time. You look at some of these guys and they you know, they're every single baseball game. They're watching every single baseball game. They're going to baseball games. Their whole life is evolved around their team. And I'm like, yeah, why don't you spend that time, you know, trying to do something else that's productive? Or even, like, you know, like, look at video games. At least if you're really into video games, you're doing hand to eye coordination, you're actually involved with it, it's making you think a little. I don't know, with sports, you're just watching people throw balls around, and half of them are on steroids, half of them are not, so it's not even fair anyway. It just seems stupid to me. I don't know, it seems barbaric.
Well, I'll say this. I mean, I see people that are excited about their teams, mm-hmm. and I don't get that way. I'm not that excited. I'm more, you know, I look at things objectively. You know, Jim Rome, who's a great radio sportscaster, he's not a fan of any teams. You know, he's a fan of, I guess, players and stuff like that, but he's not into teams. And I'm kind of the same way. I don't, unless I'm like working for the team, but when I was a kid, I was definitely, I mean, I still have the Dodgers in my heart. I grew up with them and I still like the Lakers. I lean towards them, but I'm not, I don't watch every game. I don't read the box score. I mean, listen, like, did they win or lose? But I never get, like, the last few years, I haven't been into it.
I think it's no secret where I stand on sports.
Yeah. You don't like them.
I think that they're awful. Whenever football is on in the background, it makes me uncomfortable or reminds me of boredom and weird childhood moments that I don't want to think about. And just, like, there's not enough nachos. I don't understand it. But I have a newfound respect that it's, I know that it's hard to find things in life that make you happy and, you know, are just fun to do or to be involved in. So if someone is in, has fun with sports and gets joy out of it, then I think that's okay.
That's fine. And I also I have no problem either going to a baseball game. Like if you go to a game, you get some hot dogs, you get some beers, and it's kind of fun to watch a baseball game, even though, like, I don't care who's playing who. I could go to a unknown team versus unknown team.
Should I take a call from my parents?
Sure. You know, but baseball, going to a game
Hello?
Is different.
Hi.
We're listening to this, and all I hear is that you have bad childhood memories.
Dad, turn what you're listening to down. Because
you turn your radio down at home.
Turn your radio down. I didn't have bad. It just, there was the one Super Bowl where we got into a fight, and I was sent to my room. Hello.
Yeah.
Brian, can I charge my room? I charge my iPhone.
Yeah, you guys made me stay in my room, and Mom made that seven-layer nacho dip, and I didn't get to have any.
You're lucky I didn't put you in the crawl space.
Dad, that's not...
I wouldn't even joke about that.
Dad, what are you... Dad.
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 Dad, you're lucky I didn't put you in the crawl space.
That's not safe.
Maybe we should ask Dad what she thinks about Mom and the new guy.
Brody.
Really?
What?
Your mom's got a crush on me, Esther?
Yeah, she met you in the parking lot, she said.
Yeah. We had a nice little quick conversation.
Yeah, and we saw you on Conan. We thought you were great.
Thank you. I had a good time on Conan.
I was just watching. I listen to Esther, it's always about her childhood that we abused her.
Yeah, I think she's just playing that up.
No, I think I was... I don't know.
And Brian, how are you doing?
I'm doing great. How have you been?
You're looking good.
Thank you.
All right, I'll let you say hello to your mom. Here.
What?
Goodbye.
Okay, bye.
I'm gonna put her in a crawl space.
Okay, bye. Oh my God, I'm really.
So we all know that Esther was completely telling the truth about her childhood. Wouldn't you say, Brody? Brody's
yeah.
Frozen.
Yes, I would.
Brody was frozen up. Okay, so Esther's frozen up too. Everyone's frozen up.
Oh, sorry.
Well.
Yes. Well, I think we've done. We could keep going,
mm-hmm.
But we've done over 2 hours, haven't we?
We're very close to 2 hours. We're at 1 hour and 50 minutes.
I normally do 2 hour podcasts. That's my.
That's your thing.
That's my thing now. 2 hour podcast. When you bring me in, it's a 2 hour commitment. I had a great time today.
I had a great time.
I think we had a nice conversation. Esther, did you have a good time?
I had a great time. I love this podcast. I want to do it more often.
What do you love about it?
I love that. We've been doing it for so long. I love the energy, the positive energy from Brody, the unhealthy energy from Brian. I think that it's just so much fun, and I like doing it. It's a unique experience. It's a, you know, an unlikely group.
Brian, do we get good numbers on our podcast? I know we don't do it enough.
Yeah, you do.
People always ask about it. They want another Brody and Esther.
Let's do it. We'll start doing it weekly. now that we have space here at Death Squad.
Let's try and do it next week.
We'll try to do it more.
Okay.
Maybe we can think of some night or day that's good
that we can just do it. Do
yeah, like maybe like a Sunday or something. I don't know.
Yeah.
Something weird like that.
Broden Esther.
Broden Esther. She's got...
It's like my little sister.
You know, my parents are listening, and now I regret a lot of stuff I said.
Well, I regret it, too, and I think you need to really remind me when your parents are watching, because I was saying some sexual things earlier, and I think that's awful to talk about.
Yeah, I do, too. And my car is never gone at night.
It's never gone. It's definitely not.
I just get home before you.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
You're pulling in probably a couple minutes after me. That's all.
Just a few minutes.
And that's okay.
And when we were talking about sex, that was spaghetti. We were just eating spaghetti a lot together.
Well, you know what? It's healthy and normal for young adults to have sex, so I don't think that that's a bad thing.
Oh, really? You're comfortable saying that in front of your parents?
Yeah, I mean, I don't want to... Now that I know they're listening. But yeah, I mean...
Did your parents ever walk in on you having sex?
Yeah.
Are you serious?
And we're done.
When did that happen? Esther, your parents walked in on you having sex.
Kind of, one time, but it's not a big deal.
Were you in high school?
I was in high school.
You were active sexually in high school?
I had one boyfriend.
I know. That's what I'm hearing.
And Brian's doing drugs. Mom and Dad, look at Brian.
That's not drugs, it's medicine.
Okay. Anyway, you guys have been great.
Oh, wait. Well, we can't just end on that. We have to really... See, I got caught having sex. They didn't walk in because my door was locked, but they got mad at me. My stepmom got really upset about it. Like, she just didn't want the girl in the house anymore, and she was like, you know, how dare you type shit. And I'm like, calm down. Are you saying that you didn't have sex when you were 17? Maybe not, but... They got mad. Were they when they caught me, you? Were they mad or were they?
No, they
did they
knew.
Sit there and watch for a while or gave you tips?
My parents had known. When I had sex the first time, I told them, like, it wasn't a secret because, like, I grew up. I don't know. We were honest. A lot of teenagers, I think, lie to their parents, and I never was a part of that.
Like, was culture. It like door open?
No,
catching you or no, what position were you?
Stop it, Brian. Something happened, and it just. I think it's just like startling to see. It's okay to know about, but startling to see.
Right. So, did you stop immediately? Did you cry,
Brian? I don't remember. I just.
Brody, did you ever get walked in on having sex when you were younger?
I was almost caught masturbating by my sister. I had my hand in my pants.
Your sister was helping you masturbate?
No, she saw me.
Oh.
Masturbate.
Did you ever catch her masturbate or have sex or anything?
No. I've heard her have sex vocally.
Ew.
I know.
What did that make you feel?
I was turned on. Turn me on a little bit.
A little?
No.
All right. Brody, are you anywhere this week? Weekend? What's going on with you? What's your news?
Tonight, if you're around, I'm doing Meltdown Comics at night.
Nice.
But it's for an album taping. It's not their big show.
Oh.
Taylor Williamson. But it's going to be good. Steve Renazzisi's doing it, possibly Paul Scheer. You can find me on Twitter at Brody Is Me Friend on Twitter. You can also find me on Instagram at Brode36. You can buy my t-shirts. I have a couple different t-shirts. I have stickers. You can find that on www.brodystevens.bigcartel.com. And I will be at the Comedy Store also tonight. I'll be at the Laugh Factory tonight. And you can email me at brody@brodystevens.com.
I am Esther, known as Little Esther. Can be found on Twitter under the name Little Esther. Can be found on Instagram, Esther Monster. It's a nickname I like to use now. And I have a blog. I have a Facebook page. Add me as a friend. I will accept you because I'm open and just grateful to have you. And that's it. That's all I want to say. And I have a podcast. I did a podcast with Brie Olson. You can find on my Twitter.
Ooh. I have a podcast. You can find on my Twitter too.
Sweet. Death Squad's coming to Ohio next month. Tickets are on sale right now at deathsquad.tv or brownpapertickets.com. Just search for Death Squad. Me, Tom Segura, Tony Hinchcliffe, Doug Benson, Aaron Kleber, we're all like mixing up the show. So if you want to see which lineup for which show of comics you like, just go to deathsquad.tv.
Brian, can I go on one of those shows, one of those trips?
Dude, if you want to come to this one, just get there.
Well, I'm not... I need to be flown out.
Go to Chicago.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to have you on one, the next one, whenever that is. So,
love to be a part of.
You were supposed to be on the first one back in the day. So check that out. Guys, it was so great talking to you again.
I had a great time.
Trying to do this more regularly.
Same.
And
I love...
Oh, Death Squad show Friday. Are you guys in town Friday? If you guys want to go on Ice House show?
Yeah.
I could possibly, yes.
All right, well, keep your eye out. This Friday, we have a show. If you want to go to that, go to icehousecomedy.com and search for Death Squad.
Is there a Wednesday one?
No Wednesday this week, but Friday this week. Cool. And we'll have an Ice House Chronicles, too. So.
Oh, it will? I like those.
Yeah.
Blessed.
All right, see you guys.
Bye.
See ya. Thank you. Peace. Positive energy.